Hey everyone, welcome back. Previous video, we were working inside the game settings window and we finished it off by allowing the player server to kick a player from the lobby, which will also update our player list window. So I can go ahead and kick this guy. My client's been kicked and returned to the main menu. And he's also been removed from our lobby display as well and on clients. So that's what we did in the previous video. Up next, we're going to start working on the game settings. So I click this button, the select character. I click this button and it shows our character select screen. So we're going to do that now. We'll break this up into two videos. We'll do that. And then the next video, we'll start working on the scripted functionality behind that. We're in the home stretch, so a couple more things to do. We should be done. So let's go ahead and start working on the select character window. So I'm going to close these out. And I'm going to go down to the UI and the lobby folder. And we're going to open up the game, character select screen. And drag that in. And for this, we're not going to need the canvas panel, so I'm going to delete that. And I'm going to go over to the main menu, the level. And let's open up, the host menu, I guess. Let's open that up. That's fine. I just want to copy something. So let's take our border, copy it, go to the character select, paste it. Okay. And let's make some changes. Let's see, the first thing that we'll do is this up here will be called select character, like so. Not gonna need a server name, so I can delete that. Not gonna need this, not gonna need that, 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 or that. All we're gonna have, we're gonna fill this stuff out separately. We actually don't need the accept button either. Because we're going to have the accept be when we select on one of our characters. So let's go ahead and delete this. We'll leave the spacer so it keeps back over there. So in case we don't want to select a character and just return back a menu. Okay, so that's what we have. Let's go ahead and add something else to this. We're going to need a uniform grid panel. So we're going to take this, drag and drop that on top of our vertical box. So, and I'm going to move it up above our back button so it appears there at the bottom. Our uniform grid panel, we're going to set that to fill so it fills out the whole screen like so. And we're going to add one other thing to this. Let's add a button to our vertical box. Let's move that up one like so. So it appears just above our back button. And this button is going to be called, empty button. We'll add some text on it. And this text is going to say none. So what this button will do is we have a character currently selected, but we want to assign none so that somebody else can select that character. We can either select a different character or we can press none and that will set us back to having no character selected. So that's what this will represent. So with that, let's go ahead and now start working on the character selection screen in here. So for this, what we'll do is we'll take a button, we'll drag it and drop it on top of the uniform grid panel. This first button that we do will be called a Barbarous. We're going to create one of these for each of the characters that we have. So we'll set this to stretch and stretch. And let's take a look at our uniform grid panel real quick. Just want to see something. Yeah, that's set to fill. That's fine. And we're going to populate this with a bunch of different button so it'll all start to get organized here in a second. So for this button, we're going to have some text on it too. I'm going to take some text, just put it on it, and this text is going to say Barbarous. And this text, we want it to appear at the bottom because we're going to have an image on here representing our character. We get to use those nifty thumbnails that we created way back in the day. So let's assign those under style here. Let me double check one thing. Got to make sure we do this. So let's expand that and Barbarous character. So now we can assign him. And he's kind of stretched out there. Just fine. We're going to change the draw as type to an image. Like so. So it's not a box, it's an image. And we can leave all the rest as that. That's perfectly fine. We can right click on this now and say copy. And we could say paste, and we can say paste. And so we have the normal, what it looks like normally, hovered and pressed. If you want, you can do something different for pressed, but we're just going to do the hovered here. I'm going to change the tint to are yellow, so it appears kind of yellowish when I'm hovering over it. Is that okay? And let's see, I think that's all we want to do. Let's double check this. Yeah, let's compile. And let's go to uniform grid panel. We're going to add some slot padding around this. So over here, slot padding, we'll set that to 10. And now what we'll do is make some copies of this guy. So I'm going to copy him and paste him. Let's see, one. Can I copy and paste like that? Copy, paste. Nope, sure can't. So I'm going to copy, right click, and paste. Can I do it now? Let's see. Paste. Yes, I can. So we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 characters. And we'll select the second one down. And we'll change the row and column. So it'll be row 0, column 1. And this will be row 0, column 2. Row 0, column 3. And for this guy, he's going to be row 1, column 0. Starting to come together here. 1 and 1. This guy will be 1 and 2. And finally, 1 and 3. So we have all of our setup here. Now we need to go in and populate these with the right content. So I'm going to hit F2 on this and just call this one Forge. Call this one Frosty. And hit F2 on this. Call this one Natural. F2 on this. Call this one Pit. F2 on this. Call this one Robo. F2 on this, call this one Tusk. F2 on this, call this one Warrior. So now what we need to do is go into the style section and assign the correct thumbnails for each of these. We're going to pause here and I'm going to do that. And actually, let's just do one together again just for the sake of it, and then we'll pause. So select Forge, go to Normal, change this down, Forge is who we're using. So, do the same thing for this. Forge. There we go. So now for the rest of these, go ahead and do the rest of those. Actually, let's change the text on all of these too. So this guy should say Forge. So be sure to change the text for each one of these to represent the button it's assigned, and change the thumbnails. We're going to pause and pick it back up in a second when all of those have been assigned. Okay, we're back, and you should have by now something very similar to what we have here on screen. If you've gone through and changed all of the text to match the current the thumbnail character for each button. So again, you have Barbarous, Forge, Frosty, Natural, Pit, Robo, and Tusk, and Warrior, changing all of those texts. And then on each individual thumbnail on the button, making sure that the Normal, Hovered, and Pressed each have those icons or textures that we have for our icons, that they're all set to Image. So with all of that, we are good. We can compile and save. We can close this out now. We can close the Host menu out too. We don't need that. We can go down to the UI lobby, open up the lobby menu. And our character select screen, we added it to our lobby already. We set it to hidden by default. We can size to content now. Actually, we don't want to size to content for this. We're going to stretch this one out, make this one a little bit bigger. Let's do it like that. Or however big you want it to be. Do something like this. Put it somewhere like right here. Something like that, and we'll anchor it to the center. And quick tip, we can go to the game settings here. We can hide it. We don't need to see it. We can actually hide it here as well, because it'll still show up in game. It just hides it from the view here. So like when we click game settings, it'll pop up like that. When we click, character selected does that. When we click game settings, it'll pop up like that. So it should work just fine. So let's compile and save this, and let's test this out. I'm just gonna go here. Say host a game, except we go to select a character now, pops up, and now we can cycle through all of these. We can click back, doesn't do anything yet because we haven't assigned the script for these. So We'll do that actually in the next video, but did want to get the design layout here, and we'll probably at the end, as polish, make all of these borders darker so that you don't see this behind it. But for now, I think this is good. We got it up and running. We have all of our characters in our character select screen. So we're going to pause here and we'll pick it back up in the next video where we start working on the graph portion of the character select widget blueprint. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you then.